Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Today is a Saturday, June 12th. The church celebrates the optional memorial of Immaculate Heart of the Blessed Virgin Mary. Yesterday we had the solemnity of the Most Sacred Heart of Jesus. And today we have the optional memorial of Immaculate Heart of the Blessed Virgin Mary. The Immaculate Heart of Mary is a devotional name used to refer to the interior life of the Blessed Virgin Mary, her joys and sorrows, her virtues and hidden perfections, and above all, her virginal love for God the Father. Her maternal love for her son Jesus and her compassionate love for all people. The first reading is today taken from Isaiah chapter 61 verses 9 to 11. The offspring of my people shall be known among the nations, and their descendants in the midst of the peoples, all who see them shall acknowledge them, that they are an offspring the Lord has blessed. I will greatly rejoice in the Lord, my soul shall exult in my God, for he has clothed me with the garments of salvation. He has covered me with the robe of righteousness, as a bridegroom decks himself like a priest with a beautiful headdress, and as a bride adorns herself with her jewels. For as the earth brings forth its sprouts, and as a garden causes what is sown in it to sprout up, so the Lord God will cause righteousness and praise to sprout up before all the nations. And today is a responsorial psalm from 1 Samuel chapter 2 verses 1, then 4 to 5, 6 to 7, then 8. And response is, my heart exalts in the Lord my Savior. Gospel according to Luke chapter 2 verses 41 to 51. The parents of Jesus went to Jerusalem every year at the feast of the Passover. And when he was 12 years old, they went up according to custom. And when the feast was ended, as they were returning, the boy Jesus stayed behind in Jerusalem. His parents did not know it, but supposing him to be in the group, they went a day's journey. But then they began to search for him among their relatives and acquaintances. And when they did not find him, they returned to Jerusalem searching for him. After 3 days, they found him in the temple, sitting among the teachers, listening to them and asking them questions. And all who heard him were amazed at his understanding and his answers. And when his parents saw him, they were astonished. And his mother said to him, "Son, why have you treated us so? Behold, your father and I have been searching for you in great distress." And he said to them, "Why were you looking for me? Did you not know that I must be in my father's house?" And they did not understand the saying that he spoke to them. And he went down with them and came to Nazareth and was submissive to them. And his mother treasured up all these things in her heart. Mother's heartbeat. Reflection. Today we celebrate the heart of the mother of whose heart we honored yesterday. The devotion to the Sacred Heart of Jesus began at the womb of Mary. Mary gave her unreserved yes to God, and she became an instrument of the Holy Spirit. At the moment when the Son of God took flesh in the heart of the Mary, his heart began to beat with her. Mary's heart to beat in unison with her son's heart for the love of the world. As prophesied by Simeon, her heart was pierced when she saw the heart of her son was broken. The gospel today narrates that her heart was beating for her son when she found out that the boy Jesus was missing. Her heart continues to beat for her children, for their spiritual and physical well-being. Heavenly Father, we thank you for blessing us with a great person, Blessed Virgin Mary. As we keep our memorial today of her immaculate heart, and she, we know, loves the humanity, loves each one of us. You have filled her with your love. And she was filled with the love of Christ, and in turn the Son was also filled with the love of the Mother. After the death of the disciples, you have not sent anyone back to the world, and you have sent back Blessed Virgin Mary. Her apparitions and visions are the examples of your love for the humanity. Blessed Mother, kindly intercede for us. Today the whole humanity is suffering due to this pandemic. People are in hospitals, no beds some places, no oxygen is available. Still there is suffering among the humanity. Have mercy on us, so that we may all repent and believe in your son's message. Protect this world and heal this world in the name of your son Jesus, as you brought that healing in the house of that wedding at Cana. Blessed Mother, I surrender every family today into your hands. There are orphans, widows, widowers. There are farmers, working class people. People have not even a meal per day, below poverty level, still they're suffering. Lord, have mercy on them. Blessed Mother, kindly intercede for the world. We pray so that the world may understand the salvific plan of God and accept Jesus as their Savior. Due to this pandemic, all those who lost their lives may regain the strength and hope in your Son. We pray all those who have died untimely, may their souls rest in peace. All those who are on the deathbed, have mercy on them. Raise them up in Jesus' name. Heavenly Father, I praise in the name of Jesus. You have told me whatever you bind will be bound, released will be released. I release anointing, healing, blessing and deliverance. All those listening to me right now, Lord, touch them. As you touch the man near the pool of Bethesda for 38 years, touch the woman in the marriage of 12 years, touch the deaf, dumb and mute people, touch your people, heal your people. Every doctors, nurses, hospitals, medical colleges, Lord, fill them, Lord, with grace and with the courage to face this pandemic. Bless the governments, bless those who are ruling us, Lord. Protect humanity from this present pandemic and also from the sin. Blessed Mother, can you intercede for us? We ask this through Christ our Lord. May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Father Franklin D'Souza, Diocese of Shumoga. Pray for me, friends. You can visit my website, World Wide Web, www.franklin.org. And my mobile number, also my WhatsApp number, it is, you can send your prayer requests, 9013905078. I repeat, 9013905078. Pray for me, pray for my mission. And I wish you a very happy feast of Immaculate Heart of Blessed Virgin Mary. Amen.